singing of the national anthem. Fine singing going. We'll have to have a choir with the audience someday. Yeah, that was beautiful. Well, thank you for helping us. Welcome to a new season with the Oklahoma Community Orchestra. And of course, these times provide challenges because of COVID and leftover and sometimes wearing a mask and sometimes not and all those things. But we're really happy and we decided to make this concert all orchestra, no soloists, because sometimes they haven't had a chance to play for 2 years to really get into some stuff. And so this concert is monumental and it kicks off our new season. And you can read in your program and you're, of course, always welcome to come to every one of our concerts. We move around just a little because the next one is a children's concert at Hudson Hall. And that's gonna be a monumental concert with honoring elementary school teachers. And we're gonna have hundreds of fourth and fifth graders joining us, so you may need to come and help patrol or something like that. Yeah, and then you can read about the spring concerts and all, so we have a lot of the nice things lined up. Tonight we start with the first half with three shorter pieces, all of which are, each is a monument in the literature, and Ron Nelson, the first one, is not such a well-known composer, but he's a younger American composer, and he's had great success, and this work, for instance, has been done by Boston and New York and Philadelphia and all the other great orchestras, and it's a terrific piece, Jubilee.
Thank you.
Thank you. A great opening to the season, that piece is. Now we move on to, some people say you shouldn't play Russian music now, but all the great composers that I know from Russia were nice people, you know. So I don't have anything about Rimsky-Korsakov at all. He was just a great composer, made a great contribution to all styles of music, and this next piece is from a work that was kind of a cross between a ballet and an opera. And in the second act comes this procession of noble people, and it's a magnificent march that brings royalty to the front of the line, you know, so it's great. And I add a couple of personal notes, I hope you don't mind, but I've had the pleasure two times to first play my trombone and second conduct at the Rimsky-Korsakov Conservatory of Music in St. Petersburg. And when that happens to me, that's really a treat. he of course wasn't there at the moment, but it was a great experience. Okay, please enjoy this procession. Thank you. thank you so much. Now we close out the first half with another grandiose piece. This is the Overture to Candide by Leonard Bernstein. And I've never personally experienced this, but I'm told that the New York Philharmonic did it so many times with Bernstein conducting that now it's done without a conductor and to honor him. And they frequently do the piece, but it plays itself by them because they know it upside down and backwards. Marvelous piece, lots of mixed meters, a complicated work really, but for being a musical theater piece, but it's a magnificent one. The Overture to Candide. Thank you. thank you very much. Welcome to the second half. A couple things to say. This symphony by Howard Hanson. Symphonies are sometimes more difficult for amateurs to listen to because they're long and there's multi-movement. So in your thinking gap, this is about 30 minutes of music. In this particular case, it just keeps going and going and going into some of the most gorgeous places for me and all of music repertoire, some of the most thrilling places. I think if Howard Hanson had lived a little bit later in life, he would be like the John Williams of today. Such colorful writing. And he was a great conductor, a great composer, and also head of the Eastman School of Music. He really built the Eastman School of Music into the reputation it has. And I had the good fortune of going there for two of my degrees, and I actually played the symphony under Howard Hanson, which was a great thrill, because he was a marvelous musician, and it was a heartwarming experience to play such gorgeous music from the man who created it. So not much else to say about it, just great music. Little motive here at the beginning, in the first measure you hear throughout once in a while, and there's some of the spectacular melodies and climactical places and soft places. And who would have dreamed, for instance, that the end of one of the movements, he goes clear down to a string quartet. It's just masterful writing. So enjoy this romantic symphony, number 2, Howard Hanson.
Thank you.